Hello everyone, welcome to my channel. Today I'm gonna show you guys how to remove your, how to replace your transmission filter on your Toyotas. It doesn't matter if it's front wheel drive, rear wheel drive, four wheel drive, concept is the same. So you wanna remove the oil pan, but before you remove the oil pan, you wanna drain everything. You have a drain bolt right there, and you have overflow or check bolt. So before you remove transmission bolts, see those bolts running along the drive shaft and the same thing on the opposite side? Well, on your front wheel drive, it might be a little bit different in terms of, see those bolts along the side here, they are exposed to moisture from the outside elements and they corrode. Most of the people that I talk to who already done the service, they either ship them or they break those bolts off. These are 10 mil bolts. 10 millimeter bolts, and what you want to do, you want on the top of there, on the top, apply for, give a wick. Don't be in a hurry because you're gonna end up stripping the bolts or breaking the bolts, and then we'll have to drill them out. What the bolt is on the top of there, apply some kind of liquid, a penetrating oil, give a wick, you know, every day, couple times a day, so it's all soaked. And because it will, especially if you live in the states where there is a moisture, or I guess not a dry state, rain, or it corrodes. The problem is aluminum and metal, they're not friends. They don't. Aluminum will corrode when metal is exposed to it, and metal will rust when it's exposed to aluminum. So those two metals, they're not really good friends, and they always cause each other's problems when there is a presence of moisture. That's why the bolts are either, they have some type of a covering to prevent them from corroding, but eventually the covering wears out because of the moisture presence and they start corroding, and then when time comes to remove the oil pan or some other components, it becomes an issue. So that's the first step which you want to do after draining the fluid. And let me show you on a picture, I'm going to show you guys the difference. Corroded bolt on the outside versus uncorroded, the ones that was inside. And what you want to do before you put them back together, just apply a small amount of lube. I'm not sure if you noticed not, but the edge, the back of the transmission pin was wet. And the reason why it was wet, not now, because I already removed the bolts and I was waiting for some other part. It got a lot wet with transmission fluid. It's because those bolts, the back, the three or four bolts, they were not torqued enough, were not torqued completely. That's why I was sipping, as you can see in my other clips, and the same video I'll show you guys, I'll make a note. So that's something to keep in mind, is when you're putting the bolts back together, make sure you torque to the proper specs and don't over torque it. These are small bolts, you can snap them easily, you can strip them, or you over torque, you know what I mean? That's why it's very important to stick to factory specs. Once you remove the oil pan, next step is to remove the filter. There is four bolts. Not sure if you can see or not. I just don't want to get camera up there where it's dripping. So I'm thinking about half a quart still fluid after I drain everything. The car set for about a week. Yeah, with oil pan and no fluid, more fluid actually came out. Surprisingly. So there, it looks like transmission even holds a lot more fluid. Before you replace the filter, put it back new one, make sure you remove that O-ring. It's easily removed with just a finger. Remove that O-ring and then put a new O-ring there. And make sure you just lubricate it with, you can lubricate or you don't have to, there's enough residual ATF up there. So, but it doesn't hurt to lubricate, so when the new filter just goes in very smoothly. This is what the O-ring looks like. So this is what the old filter looks like. A new filter is exact replacement. Even the numbers on it match exactly. So that's the part number right there. It's a genuine. Can you use aftermarket? You can.
Nothing wrong with the quality aftermarket. I don't mean cheap stuff that sometimes falls apart inside your transmission. Yes, you can use aftermarket. Just make sure it's exact same fit. But you can use aftermarket if you know the part number. There's a lot of companies that make aftermarket filters, and there's nothing wrong using. As you know, I use aftermarket for engine oil and so on. So that's the part number. Same thing on this one, on the brand new filter. Later, PA60CGF33. Same part number, same filter. So it looks like it's a original, genuine filter that has. I don't know if it's been replaced or not. I don't have that. I don't have any records of proof. But I guess we'll go with what we have. The old O-ring and the new O-ring. There's a part number. So when you put it on top of it, they match. So that way you know you got the same O-ring. So there you go. So if you need a part number, that's the part number for your O-ring, for transmission, strainer. With my case, I'm gonna clean the oil pan. As you can see, there's magnets. There's enough fine metal on them. Clean the oil pan. I'm gonna replace the gasket. Not sure the gasket, doesn't look like the gasket been replaced. So probably the transmission pan was never dropped. Because you can see, not sure if you can see or not, but there's little cracks. So the bolts, what I'm talking about, galvanic corrosion, I'm gonna show you how to deal with this. And so let's clean the pan and go from there. So I'm not gonna replace my original oil pan on my Toyota Tundra. I'm gonna install a new one. Why is it? Why is my changing fluid or changing filter turn into this and a quite expensive job? You know, now I end up buying a completely brand new oil pan. Well, the reason why, because the drain plug, that drain plug right there, now this is overflow, this is for checking the level, was stripped. Unfortunately, it was stripped. So when I was draining the fluid, it barely came out. So I'm like, you gotta be kidding me. So now I end up replacing it, and you know what I mean, people say, oh, it has to be, if it's done by the dealer, it's perfect. Well, you gotta remember, there are people at the dealers that don't care about the quality, about other people's vehicles too. There are people that care. There's, you know, we live in a world where there's different type of people. There's those that care and there's those don't care about anything. So now, a simple fluid change turned into quite expensive. So this here, the oil pan, it's not terribly expensive. It's about $853, $150 with the tax. You know, you got 15% discount by asking the gentleman at the parts stores. And I'm buying a brand new plug for it. This is the part number. Well, actually, this is for the overflow. And this is the part number for the drain plug. So that's pretty much it. Of course, brand new washer is going to be installed. That's the part number if you want to look it up online by yourself. A brand new gasket will be installed. So this is a brand new gasket. This is the part number for the gasket. You can pretty much order everything online as long as you know the part number. And this is for 2012 Tundra with 4.6. The transmission is 8760F. So that's a transmission. So these are brand new washers. Crush washers, they're one-time use, and that looks like the part number the dealer wrote. So that's what it looks like, and we'll go from there. By the way, this is the second oil pan, the transmission pan, because the first one that I ordered, it had deep gouges. This one, it was damaged pretty good, actually. As you can see, look at those scratches. It was a lot worse shape. Not sure if you guys can see it or not. That's why they have all those scratches. That it was a lot worse condition, so I told them I need a new one. And that's the part number. And looks like everything is made in Japan. So if you're ever interested, or in case you ever need an oil pan for your 4.6 Tundra or Sequoia, or maybe Lexus GX, so that's what it looks like. And before you install new oil pan, make sure it's clean, you know, wipe it clean, use the transmission fluid to wipe it clean to pick up all the small particles, or not sure, maybe brake parts cleaner would be a good idea. I'm not sure if it's good or not. I don't know if it's going to remove the paint or not, but the edges where the gasket is going to be sitting, there looks like something is on it already. As you can see, even parts from the dealer, they're not perfect. So the gasket for the, or the O-ring is in already. I installed the lubricant with the fresh oil. Now, what I'm doing is installing the filter itself, the strainer, whatever you want to call it. Make sure your hands are clean. You don't want to introduce any dirt, and straightforward. Maybe a good idea to loop this area to help the fit in, slide in to the, on the, onto the O-ring. Yeah, your best option is to remove the O-ring, slide it on the strainer itself. That's the way I'm doing it, because otherwise it doesn't want to go in. There you go. See how perfect it's now? Make sure these bolts are clean, no dirt. These bolts are torqued to 7 foot-pounds. 7 foot-pounds. So if you don't have a torque wrench, I strongly advise you to get one yourself. It doesn't have to be an expensive brand, as long as it can read that with good accuracy, you know, 3% or less, or 1-2% of an accuracy. 7 foot-pounds is not much. What you want to do, if you're not sure, have a feel for it, put a wrench on your torque wrench and just try it with your hand, you know what I mean? See how much force it takes for you to feel that it's a 7 foot-pounds. You know, try it with less first. Try maybe 5 or 6 foot-pounds and then move up to 7. Once you're done torquing your filter bolts, next to clean your oil pan where the gasket goes in around the perimeter of transmission, clean it with a, don't spray there, spray on the rag, or best to use shop towels, spray on the shop towel, clean the whole area, make sure there is no fluid, there is no dirt, nothing, and then start installing your transmission pan. So the torque for the bolts, according to Toyota specs specification, 62 inch pounds, roughly it's 5.1 foot-pounds. My torque wrench starts about 5 foot-pounds and goes up to, I think, 100 or 200 or something, 125. So not very good tool to use it. I need something smaller, which is I don't have it. So I was able to torque one bolt because it's a long handle and it's kind of easy. It's hard to tell, you know what I mean, if you're ready to snap it or not. So I did by hand everything kind of by the feel, then use the torque wrench, but I guess it's up to individual, depending on what's your skills level. You can get stuff inch torque, something smaller, torque it, or torque it by hand, it's up to you, it's your personal choice.
So this is how you replace your transmission filter. So now I'm going to put the plugs and start doing adding the fluid and measuring the fluid. See the next step. That's going to be in the next video. There will be a link at the end of this video where you can watch how I added the fluid and how to measure the fluid.